Welcome to This Is My Architecture. I am Han from AWS, and today I have Chad from PayGo. Welcome, Chad, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
So before we get into your architecture, can you tell me a little bit about PayGo?
Yeah, you bet. Are you familiar with prepaid cell phones or smartphones?
Yeah.
PayGo does exactly the same thing, but for utilities for your house. Our application allows customers to see near real-time usage information and make payments.
Awesome. So let's just say I am a customer of PayGo. Can you walk me through the flow?
Absolutely. So the first thing that you're going to do is visit your utility branded website. You can do that on your smartphone or any device that will reach the internet. Once you're there, you're going to take a look at data that's provided by our EC2 system. If you need to make a payment, for example, let's say your balance is a little low, you're going to make a payment through the web portal. That information goes to the actual utility company. Once the utility company receives that, they're going to communicate with a meter on your house. If the meter on your house is disconnected, it'll turn on in about 25 seconds.
That is awesome. So listen, walk me through, like, in terms of payment. How does that flow work?
You bet. There's a couple different methods. We just discussed how you can do it on the web portal. We also have a patented process called checkout.
Wow.
What checkout allows customers to do is they can receive a barcode on their mobile phone or on their actual paper utility bill. They'll take that barcode to a participating retailer, such as Walgreens or CVS or any of the other participating retailers. Scan the barcode. Business rules will check a variety of things. Are you still a customer? Can you make a payment? You're not making a payment that's too large. Once those business rules have been evaluated, that payment is going to go into our system, and once more it will flow to the utility company and then affect the meter that actually exists on your house. Once the payment is made, you get a real-time notice on your mobile device in case you have to happen to have that with you.
So how do you persist all this data? How is that managed?
You bet. All of that is managed inside of our environment, our application ecosystem that resides in EC2. A lot of meter data is managed by the utility company, but the actual payment processing runs through our patent process inside of AWS.
Awesome. So I noticed that you have a database in EC2 there.
Yes.
I'm not seeing an RDS. Can you tell me why?
You bet. Yeah. The answer is history. So when we first took a look at AWS, what we discovered is that we were using features that RDS did not support at that time. Our only option was to run SQL Server on a Windows operating system inside AWS. We took a look at the other major cloud providers too.
Yep.
Guess what? They couldn't do it. AWS was the only place that we could go.
So how do you maintain the high availability disaster recovery with this?
Yeah, great questions. What you see here in the EC2 in the database, this is one half of a two-sided stack.
Okay.
There is this stack in each of an availability zone inside a region. That provides our high availability. Over here with S3, we're backing up all the data to S3. That data then is cross-region replicated over to another region. That's the irreplaceable part. We can build instances, which we would do. We can spin those up in load balancers, but we can't turn on DR without that data. Over in DR, we also have a double-sided stack as well for high availability.
So it must be a manual process that you're running today.
Yes, some of the pieces are manual, and we hope to make that better in the future.
So what's next for PayGo?
Yeah, thanks. So first off, we would really like to use more of AWS's native services. AWS has a global reach, which is wonderful for us, because in case we go globally, AWS can support that. We're going to move from the SQL Server on an operating system over to RDS, and we also like to get into a lot of infrastructure automation and orchestration. Right now, it takes a few days to build an environment. With that, as you know, we could move that from days down to hours.
That's phenomenal. So thank you so much for going over your architecture. That's very awesome how you're able to enable the utilities with just a click of a button for your mobile. So thank you.
You bet.
And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.